It's 12 o'clock on a Wednesday and this is the Wizard Product Review. We're back after our little break. I'm Dave.
I'm Wayne.
And on this week's show, first of all, we are going to talk about some of the latest releases that we've had a little butchers over, but we have to mention Lads. Thank you very much for coming to Lads.
Thank you.
It was a great day.
Wasn't it? It was absolutely brilliant. It really, hard work though.
It was hard work.
Felt like I had my day job back.
What was your highlight of Lads this year?
Aaron and Tom.
Yeah,
Aaron and
you
Tom,
love that.
I knew that was going to happen. Aaron and Tom did take it apart. There was so much. Morgan was obviously brilliant, as we all said it was. I liked the Saturday night before.
Yeah.
I liked the Saturday night before, all getting
my highlight, you'll need to ask around this. I don't know if he's got a pamphlet on it or something like that, but my highlight was Luca Volpi's Italian pre-show technique. And that's all I'm going to say about it. You have to be there.
You should have been there.
And it's a good technique.
Okay, it was good, mate.
For pre-show.
Yeah.
But you have to be there to hear about that.
That's funny.
52-1 deck. Oh my God, what has happened, Wayne?
It feels like being a celebrity. It's bonkers. It's madness. It's brilliant.
Thank you so much for all the messages. Personally, I'm sorry that we haven't responded to everyone. Apparently this thing...
I've not been able to.
It has gone crazy. I know people say things like that, but like literally every single day messages about people that are loving the 52-1 deck. World Magic Shop have got a few left in stock, but it's sold out worldwide everywhere. Every other magic dealer, because the majority of the stock went straight to the international distributor. And in less than 48 hours... the whole thing was sold out, and unfortunately now for every other dealer in the world, it's another 5 weeks until it's actually available again.
In the 12 years that I've been in the marketplace to sell magic, I've never known waking up to so many products that are sold on a list on your email. Said, I've just...
lot of magic dealers have said it's the most successful pre-order they ever had, which is incredible. So thank you. We just wanted to say that we're glad everybody
thank
is
you.
Loving it. And
amazing.
Thank you once again. We'll let you know when it's back in stock worldwide, of course, still available from worldmagicshop.com. The first of the products we're going to look at this week is Social Networks, the game. It's kind of like a custom printed deck. It's not on bicycle stock. These cards are kind of like plasticky, aren't they?
They have got a bit of an air cushion feel to it. They've got a little bit of a linen look and feel.
And
they spread like a regular deck of cards as well.
We will put obviously normal clips on the screen so you can have a look at these. It comes with an instructional download. The download is very comprehensive.
Yeah.
It's got about 2 hours worth of instructions. You see mostly, but they go through the deck first of all, the guys, the creators, and they tell you how it's marked and that kind of thing, and how these individual cards could be used in effects. And then you see some performances of effects, and then they go through the explanations. Probably the strongest effect we agreed with each other was the out of this world using these cards, the thumbs up and the thumbs down. I don't think it's an out of this world that's going to fool magicians.
It won't.
The unique things about it is the fact that it uses this deck.
Yeah.
And I guess that's the main selling point of this deck. You're using emojis and Facebook symbols rather than just black cards and red cards.
I can see the appeal in it. I can see it. In fairness, though, it's really not for me. I think too many people will be Googling what this is, trying to figure. I just don't understand.
What if they do Google what it is? They're just going to say social network playing cards.
I guess so. I just don't understand what the idea of...
Don't you agree, though, that for most of the routines, the actual... the deck itself isn't actually the secret. What they've done here is they've actually taken existing magical routines and put this emoji Facebook slant on it. Like, something was just a simple card force, for example. I forget what the routine was called. Was it... I did write it down. I had some notes over here. I should grab those notes. I know I had them somewhere. Yeah, it was called... Obsession. And Obsession started with him taking a photo. So he got the spectator to kind of sit there and he took a picture of holding an emotion, yeah. and he pulled the expression of the emotion, and then when she dealt through the cards randomly, it ended up and it was actually that emotion. And it was enhanced by the fact that it was using these cards rather than just a playing card. Allegedly. Hey,
yeah,
the out of this world were mixed, and it was thumbs up, thumbs down. It was all talking about emotion. The mirror routine, the empathy routine, where the two spectators thought of the same emotion.
Yeah.
It was all based on
the out of
existing
this world,
routines.
Yeah, it is everything that's in there is stuff that's already you're doing with a deck of cards, which is my point.
Well, that's my point. Why it's good.
Yeah.
Well,
okay.
Go on.
I just don't. It just doesn't do it for me. It's not doing it for me. I can't.
You think these look like toy shop magic?
Yeah.
Like
it looks like something my kids had when they were little.
Yeah.
Like flashcards. You know, and it kind of gives it a little bit of a childish edge to it. I'll definitely not be walking around doing that. It would bring my magic down to a lower level of a children's.
I know what you mean.
You know, yeah, it's not. They're very well made.
Some of the cards do look very childish.
Yeah.
But the thumbs up and thumbs down ones, I don't think they do. I think they look like icons, and that's got a different feel
to it. This is something that you would do for children, and yet I don't think that the complexity of the effect isn't for children. You'll get a better reaction if you get a decent reaction from adults.
Well, at the end, the plots themselves, the performances, I know the guys are working in their second language, but I did find them a little bit drawn out and a little bit dull as well, if I'm honest. They weren't sort of straight to the point.
Yeah.
I thought the Out of This World could have had a bit more energy, but they seemed like a lot of talk. But
it was hard to watch.
I'm making allowances here because the guys are obviously performing in their second language, but I thought a lot of the routines that were suggested did lack pace and excitement, and they didn't give you that feel, wow, that's good, that's exciting.
I agree.
But I think somebody out there might find a use for these, might use these existing cards that are marked very, very well and create their own routines.
I have to say that. They are marked well. They are made well. They are going to last. That's all the good things.
You just don't feel comfortable using them. How much are you going to give it?
48%.
48%. I'm going to give it 67%. Okay. A little bit more, but actually I was going to give it a little bit more, but then you brought up that point about the childish look of them, and the more I think about what you said, I agree with Wayne on that. Hole in One is a visual bit of eye candy by the Sans Minds Creative Lab that came up with this.
And this is proper eye candy.
What, describe the effect.
Have a dollar bill that they have in there, big crowd around them, holding it out like that. They give it a little stretch, and a hole appears, a really neatly cut hole appears in the bill, and in its place in the spectator's hand is a dime, isn't it, or a coin or such?
Yeah, quarter.
Underneath, which you can see through the bill. It looks brilliant.
It does
look very good.
Once you got past Jason's little comedy set, where he goes 7-Eleven, and you know, in 1, 2, 3 weeks, I'm off. He can't do comedy.
He can't do it.
Jason, you can't deliver a line.
No.
You can't deliver a line, but your magic's really good and really visual. And the hair's working for me now, isn't it? What do you think of his hair? Silver hair?
It's not for me.
Obviously, I should do it.
11%.
Jason tribute. But the actual effect, that Jason does here, that the Sans Minds Creative Lab came up with, it does look really good.
It does look really good, yes.
Very visual. The gimmick looks incredibly deceptive. It's a little bit of an arts and crafts project. You get some bits with it construct it. You like that sort of thing.
Yeah, it's all right.
Me, not so much, but I know it's a necessity in these days of mass-produced magic to kind of keep costs down and allow people to make their own gimmicks. But when you make it, and when you make it really well, with a dollar bill, it's going to look really, really good. Mm. I think you'd have to use a £20 note if you were going to do it in England to make it look good, and then it's going to be quite an investment. Mm. But if you were using this on a little social media video, I think it does look very, very good indeed.
Yeah. It's not the thing.
Here's the thing.
Oh, go on.
You're going to say it.
Yeah.
You say it. You read my mind.
I'm not going to walk around performing this.
You're not going to do it at a gig.
No.
But you like it. If you were on a TV show and your magic consultant said you were doing this today, you'd go, great, I love that trick. It's great. It looks really good, even though it's not got TV rights with it. But if you were going to do it on your social media channel, I think the effect is great. It's really, really visual. I was surprised with it. The gimmick is very, very clever, and the effect is stunning, and it's so visual.
Mm.
It's not for a gigging close-up magician. It falls into that category of visual eye candy, great for show reels, that kind of thing.
That, yeah, that kind of stuff. Having it with you all the time. I love a bit of coffee shop magic, don't I, Dave?
Yeah.
I love having magic with me all the time when I'm not actually at a gig. If you're just out with friends, having a drink, bite to eat, in a restaurant, and someone says, do some magic, it falls in my nest of always being prepared.
Yeah.
And you're going to do something really good.
You can't borrow the dollar bill or note, or you could, but then you've got to switch it in. You've got to switch in your gimmick. At the end, if you want to give away the very same gimmick with a hole in, you have to remove the gimmick from it. Although this is explained on the DVD, I can't see this being that easy to do. On the fly, you need to have a lot of misdirection, a lot of people screaming around and running around in central Canada in the early hours of the morning, and when they're that misdirected, you'll be able to get away with this cleanup. I think in the real world you'd struggle cleaning up that easily. I might be wrong. I'm just going on what I've seen from the first watch. I agree with you, mate.
But the actual moment, clean up, that's gonna be hard.
The moment looks brilliant. I'm not going to use it because I'm not going to go out and gig with it, and I've got so much material, it's not going to make its way into my set. But I did like it.
Mm.
How much are you going to give it?
I'm going to give it 73.
Yeah, I'm going to give it 72%. 72%. A lot better than I thought. Great visual moment of magic.
Eye candy. It's
quite a bit of arts and crafts, though. I first got to see this at Magic Live this year in Las Vegas.
Yeah.
And Greg Ostrami had it on his stand. It's just been released, Inject 2.0, which is getting App of the Month this month.
Rightly so.
And it is amazing, mainly because you don't even need to use your phone, which is quite unusual for app magic. There are some incredible effects you can do. You've certainly got your favourite.
I have.
I've got my favourite. One of the great things about it is it uses something that people trust all the time. We're going to dem one of the effects on there right now. Can I ask you on your phone, Wayne? We haven't set this up. This could be a borrowed phone.
Yeah, honestly, this is just...
Can I ask you to go to your phone, go to google.com, and I'm going to get you to type something in a moment.
Okay, Google.
And I don't know if you know, so there's Wayne's phone there on Google. I do hope you can see that on the screen. I'll bring it a little bit closer. I don't know if you know that if you go onto google.com and you actually put in birthday of, and you actually type birthday of, and then you put a celebrity's name. So let me just show this to the camera just here. I've just typed in birthday of just there into Wayne's phone. If after birthday of Wayne, you put the name of any celebrity. Now, don't put George Michael, because I know you're a very big George Michael fan. Oh, look at that, it's changed the white balance slightly. Can you put a celebrity's name? And because I put birthday of before, when you Google that and press search, it will tell you, hopefully, when that celebrity was actually born. But make sure this is a celebrity I don't know. And
Celebrity you don't know?
Celebrity I don't know. Somebody totally random. And it's somebody you're searching for, right?
Yeah, I've searched it, yeah.
Okay. Can you think, does it say there the month this celebrity was born in?
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm just going to say, try not to give anything away. Try not to give anything away at all. Just look at me. My God, you're attractive. January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September.
Did I give something away?
Say the month this celebrity was born in.
July.
It is actually July. I've written down July. So straight away, you've got a reveal there. You can do the same thing now with the day that they were born in. So it could be the 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th, 13th, 14th, 15th, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20th, 21st, 22nd, 23rd, 24th, 25th, 25th? No. It's the 24th. It is this celebrity
try
born.
Try to second guess you there.
On the 24th of July.
Yeah.
So straight away, you've got your second reveal there. Make sure you take in that Wayne has actually typed this in on his phone. He's typed it in on his phone. And we already know the birthday that he's come up with. Now, can you think of the celebrity that you freely chose?
I am thinking.
This is a female, isn't it?
Oh,
this
yes.
is somebody that makes you very happy.
Oh, you wouldn't believe it.
Are you thinking of a certain part of this celebrity's body right now?
I am
Are
now.
You thinking of their bottom?
I am now.
Oh my goodness. Are you thinking of J-Lo?
Damn right I am.
So there we go. You've got J-Lo just there. And another amazing effect that you can do with Inject. We'll put some footage on the screen. You can now borrow another spectator's phone. You do not need to use your own phone during this. In fact, your own phone can be dead. You don't need to use your own phone once you've got yourself your Inject account set up. You could borrow somebody else's phone, go to Google, and on somebody else's phone, you could get that first person to think, just think of the celebrity that they're,
this is what
they're
thinking
of.
This is what you've done before. It looks brilliant.
You need more people for this to kind of work.
Yeah.
So at this point now, and you'd have a more relaxed environment,
yeah.
You might go to your own phone, for example, and you'd go, oh, I'm not actually on the Wi-Fi. Do you have data? Do you have data there? Can we try this with you? We know the birthday. We know it's July the 24th.
Yes.
I think I know who you mean, but just think of that celebrity. And when you wave your hand over the top of the spectator's phone, another spectator's phone, immediately
it
populates with images of that spectator. And this is just one of the effects that you can do with Inject. It has to be one of the most versatile apps out there. You know, we spoke about Wikitest before, which is an amazing app.
Yeah.
But this has got to be one of the most versatile apps because that is one of the things that you can do. Think about all these impression devices that magicians can get. And yet, with this, it's like using a spectator's phone and something they trust.
Exactly.
Like
yeah.
Google.
Mm-hmm.
And you will know what that spectator has put.
Yeah.
In Google, and you can access that information. You can manipulate that information. You can preempt it with different text. You can go star sign of, or something like that. And it's hard without going into too much of the secrets, but there is so much you can do with this app. You particularly liked the posting the picture.
Oh yeah.
Of that. Yeah, you're already going to set this up with a picture of you holding one card.
And the reflection of the number and the suit is in the person's eyes. I'm going to have it on my aviator, so it's going to be a picture of me
holding a playing card.
Yeah, holding a playing card back to the face towards me. I'm holding it here, and then the reflection of the playing card. So I have a little seven in the reflection. It's just going to be brilliant.
You are going to need to do a little bit of work to set that up, and if you join the Inject users group, there are a lot of people in there that are very, very helpful and provide a lot of advice, because the thing with Inject, it is a minefield. There is a guy that actually sells like a little booklet as a download, which I would recommend you getting. I can't think of the guy's name. Maybe I'll put it up on the screen. But he sells like a guide to all the features that are available, because the one feature that Wayne described there means that you can post a picture of yourself on somebody's timeline. Now, I know Greg does it with his business card. And when they've then freely named a card or chosen a card, Greg has them zoom in on the address on the business card. And it actually says, as part of the address, the two of hearts or something like that. Mm. But you can do it with a photo as well. So when they zoom in on the photo, just the corner of the aviator glasses has actually got the picture on there.
Yeah.
And it's fully customizable. It is amazing. It's one of many effects you can do with it. Have a look around. Go on YouTube, put Inject Magic Trick in YouTube, and there's a video that's about 30 minutes long. So many more features have been added since then with Inject 2.0. But
this is the tip of the iceberg, isn't it?
You can see all the features and all the effects that you can do with this one app. Although, if you go on the App Store, it is available for free. That is a very basic effect that you get for free. And with an in-app purchase, you do have to invest. I think it's like £75 or something like that. Yeah. Certainly around that price, you will then get the full app and its full capabilities with its customizable interface, which is a little bit tough to explain and go into and hard to understand. Even I've not got completely to the bottom of it, but I love the fact that they can search on Google and you can manipulate this information and incorporate it into
your
presentation.
Tip of the iceberg stuff. Tip of the iceberg stuff.
It is very, very good. It's getting App of the Month.
Yeah.
But we've also got three codes to give away. Now, if you want to win Inject 2.0...
I want to win it.
We're going to give away one code for somebody who simply comments on this video within Facebook. So if you're watching this now on Facebook, if you're watching it on YouTube, go to the World Magic Shop Facebook page, find the same video, and just put a comment below. Any comment you like. Something good about 52 to 1 would be kind of good.
There ain't nothing bad.
Or something that you want us to review in the future, or perhaps a memory of lads or something like that, or a comment on the show, perhaps a review that you agree with or a review that you don't agree with, but comment on the show. Next time we come back, we'll give you away a code for you to own Inject 2.0. And also we'll have two winners chosen from any orders this week from worldmagicshop.com. So if you order any of the latest products, including the 52 to 1 deck from worldmagicshop.com, remember any orders over £50 or free shipping within the UK, you will get entered into a draw. We'll draw that on the show as well. Next time on the show, we'll give away three codes for Inject 2.0, and it is brilliant, it is fantastic, which is why we're giving it App of the Month on the Wizard Product Review this month.
Okay, up next by Lokai Cross is Sonic Stab. This is this is a classic, isn't it? It's a classic of Magic. Close up level.
Card stab.
Very unusual card stab. They get to choose a card as they would normally. Gets put back in the pack. They get then sprung into the air, and the performer has his earphones on. He flicks them over his head, and it smashes through and stabs.
When he's got his earphones on, they're not in, because that would hurt your ears,
yeah,
wouldn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, and then you nut them.
He has it round his neck.
Yeah, and he flicks it out, and it stabs their chosen card. Do you like this one? Do you like this one, Dave?
I do like it. Although I kind of knew how it worked before I watched it,
I thought I knew how it worked. That worried me a little bit because I was thinking, will a layperson look at this and now think, I think I know how that one works.
I do think it's very visual. I do think it's very cool. It's got that problem that all card sword routines have, which is fine if you're in a theatre and you're throwing the cards at them, you're stabbing with the sword, thank you very much, and the curtains close, yeah. And then all the stagehands come on with the brushes when the curtains are closed. Yeah. But actually, there are a few places I work and venues I've worked where they wouldn't actually like it if you threw loads of things up in the air and ended up with cards all over the floor.
Yeah.
On the street, I don't think it looks very good because it looks like a little bit of a litter bug and you definitely don't want to do it there. So it's got that inherent problem that I don't like about card stabs. Saying that, I do like the fact that it appears on the headphone. Excuse me. I do like to do things with mobile phones these days. I think the headphones looks great. I do like it that although it doesn't appear in the live performance, the gentleman who takes you through the instructional video, he explains how you can do it where you get the headphones examined, you put it around their neck, your neck, then they look at a card, and they then look at the card. It's not signed, is it?
It's not signed.
They look at a card, you turn around. It is possible to then turn back and take the same headphones around your neck and flick them forward. But it's not that easy, and I'm not sure how it would work during a routine. But I like the visual moment of catching the cards on the headphones.
It's just that thing. I just don't know when I would be performing that.
You're not going to do this.
I'm never going to be able to.
You're not the headphone around the shoulders kind of guy.
I am not that kind of bloke. I don't like it because you are just left with all these cards all over the floor. And it should really be something that you would be closing the first half of a small parlour show with or something like that. It's just so that you can reach in and tidy up afterwards.
The visual's good though, isn't it?
It looks brilliant. It does look good. It does look like it flicks on there. I think people...
Do you know, isn't it like a lot of Sans Mind stuff? I was just thinking about that now, thinking about the last review, that you kind of, you have this moment where you go, visually, it's quite stunning, actually.
Mm.
But then you start to think, when am I going to use it? And you've got this battle going on with a lot of Sans Mind material. Yeah. Maybe it is an age thing and just something I need to face up to, that it, magic is changing, but... It's that kind of, yes, it looks good, it looks visual, I like that. You get that sort of euphoria when you watch the screen. You go, wow, that looks good. And then you start to think about, but actually, when am I going to do this?
It is very difficult now, though, Dave, because we are professional magicians and have been for 20 years each, I guess. But you do look at this kind of thing and you do sit there and look at it as a magician.
Yeah.
You've got to step out of it and go, as a layperson, how would I feel when I saw that? Then you step back into the box and go, right, as a magician, when am I going to perform that? So we do have to weigh that up.
Do you know an effect that is like that, that you just reminded me of? And I've had a lot of comments about the release of Keymaster Chrome.
Yeah.
And a lot of magicians have kind of watched the trailer and gone, oh, yeah, I can kind of see what he's doing there. But actually, they you do forget as a magician. And when I'm using Keymaster, the reaction that it gets from spectators that aren't able to watch a video and then go, right, well, I've watched the video, now I know what happens, I'm going to look back and look where he put his fingers at certain points and that kind of thing. And I'm going to backtrack on the whole thing, oh yeah, I know, it works now. It is difficult as a magician, isn't it, when you can't actually react to the first time you saw something.
Tricky one, it really is.
Like a zigzag illusion for me. I remember looking at a book with a zigzag illusion in, with Robert Harbin actually doing it. And I remember studying the pictures and not knowing how it was done.
Mm.
Not knowing. And genuinely now, I feel a little bit sad that I kind of can see how it's done. And
it's
how
like
most
finding,
magic's done.
Watching, reading a book and then going through the explanation before you've read the effect.
Yeah.
Because you're thinking, yeah, it sounded good, sounded good. Yeah, let me just read
then
about that.
Then you're disappointed.
That. Yeah, and you are. So, what are you going to give
with
this?
That in mind, how are we going to score it? I don't know if I'm going to use it, but I do think visually it looks stunning. I'm going to give it 80%.
Are you?
Exactly 80. I think I might be tempted at one stage to use this, but in the future I can't see that time. But with the type of magic that I do, I think it might end up on a video somewhere.
It is nice. Yeah, I'm going to give it 72.
72%. But yeah, will they work it out though?
Could reverse engineer it.
Last review this week. Unfortunately, quite a lot of Sans Mind's products made their way onto the review pile. We've got some new items coming in for the next Wizard product review. But this was Holy Change.
Yeah.
So Holy Change is an effect where a card is taken from a red-backed deck, from a red-backed box, and they take a red card out, or if you've got the other version, you know, it's going to be the opposite way around. They sign the face of that card.
They do.
You cleanly take that red card and it's displayed between two white cards with a giant hole in it, and you can clearly see that it's a red card, and yet when you push it, it visually changes to a blue card, kind of like a mini illusion.
Yeah.
I got to say up front, I really like this. I like the fact that in a show, you could frame it as something quite impossible. It looks like a mini illusion. It's like doing an illusion. I spoke to a good friend of mine, Matthew McGurk, with his partner Katia, that does a whole sleight of hand show on a ship. I've spoken to him about this, and he loves this. He absolutely loves this effect, because it's kind of like, not like pick a card, take a card. You've kind of got that moment, like WoW, like using the WoW gimmick, you know, the clear plastic sleeve, where if you're using a camera on a stage show or on a ship, you can have that camera focused, and there's a definite moment where it goes boom and changes. Mm. And he loves this effect. I love it for that reason as well. I really do like this.
Okay, right, I don't.
Why? It looks great. Put it up again. I'm going to put it on again while you're talking.
While I'm talking about
and
it.
And everyone's listening going, Wayne doesn't know what he's talking about. That looks amazing.
Okay, here's the reasons why I don't really think it. I don't like card tricks that have been pre-made.
Yeah, well, we're going back to that point from before. You're a worker, Wayne. You need a deck to come out of your pocket, maybe have you know, presenting your magic more like a show, like Matt, and sometimes I do on stage with a camera, or you're doing a parlour show, sometimes it isn't okay to have these other props that you might have to reach into a briefcase for. But you don't like that.
I don't like that kind of magic. No, I really don't. And I know that I appreciate that other people will like this, and I also appreciate that it visually looks brilliant.
However, there you go then, that's the end of the review. There's your quotes right there.
Not.
Sam's Mind's Magic.
No, it's not. That's
Wayne
not.
Fox was a product review. Visually, that looks brilliant. That's all they needed. You've given it to them.
Yeah, I've done it, haven't I? It visually looks brilliant, but I just don't understand. Shut up. I just don't understand what for me, when I used to see card tricks, like before I was a professional magician, before I was a magician, I was just a teenager. I'd look at stuff like that and think, what? Why has it got two holes in it anyway? Why is that?
Well, there's been other effects like that before. Anthony Owen had a version a while ago with a hole like that where the card
again, it does look, but I do question it. I look at that and go, what is the hole? I don't understand. What did you cut
to isolate the impossibility? It's sandwiched between these two cards, so I can't get to it. I can't use any sleight of hand. You can see the card above and below, but
if
ladies
you
and
cut
gentlemen,
an hole
watch,
in it, poof. If you've cut an hole in it, what else you've done with it?
It's a good psychology. It's good. It's good thinking. I
if
know
you
what
cut
you're doing.
An hole in it. What else you done with it?
Does your audience
that
think that
perfectly
way?
Round? If it was bored out and they've seen you roughly cut it out with a dirty pair of scissors,
yeah, you'd like it then.
Yeah, tore it out. That's I've done. I've.
You created something.
Let me
don't
get
say
on the
any
phone.
More. Create it.
I've created. Yeah, yeah. I've. Don't you dare copy that idea. Just because I said it. Just because I said it, I'll be round.
I think Paul Harris probably did it in 1982 anyway, if we go back and look at the archives.
No doubt.
How much are you going to give this? Last review of the week. Everything's been a little bit not so good.
Yeah, it didn't do it for me this one, I'm afraid. I'm going to give it 62%.
62%. I'm going to give it 91%.
Because
I've got a use for this, and I actually...
No, I knew you were going to use
like it.
I knew
really
you were
going like
to use it.
Not sure how it's going to go over, but I like it, and I think it's like a mini illusion. I think it looks great as part of a 10-minute magic on a camera in an illusion show. I've already got a place for it. I'm going
to
use this.
I'm coming
to
that gig, and I'm going to listen to the audience going, what else has he done with those cards? What else has he done with those?
You'll listen to them... going wild, going, that's incredible. That'll get a, you know that's going to get a, from the audience.
And that's going to get a, from you.
Yeah, he'll get that from me. I'll do it. See better turn my mic off, John, during that part of the show. That's it this week for the Wisdom Product Review. Got to say it again. Thank you very much for coming to Lads. Thank you very much for supporting us.
Thanks all the stuff for the 52-1 deck as well.
With the 52-1 deck and Keymaster Chrome and the beer bottle production that has just come out. And Sean said thank you for all the support for his... multiple card find project. Which has just come out. So many releases this month from World Magic Shop. Don't forget, any orders over £50 automatically get free shipping in the UK, and you'll be entered into a draw to win Inject 2.0, which is this week's app of the month on the Wizard Product Review. Until next time, I'm Dave.
I'm Wayne.
See you next time on the Wizard Product Review. Good boy.